Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Do you know what time it is? It's your time to shine, because I'm going to play for you, teach for you, and entertain to you guys some December blackjack. Place your bets, shuffle up, and deal. Let's do this. And folks, forgive me if the camera falls over, I'll pick it up, put it back in its original position. I know, that's happened to me before. But you know what, guys? I don't really care if I become a hit sensation or not one of these days, if you all watch this video. But I am going to start three hands of blackjack this time with $60. That's 20 bucks a square. $60 is my weekly allowance out of my whole fucking paycheck in SSI, and it sucks. So that's what I'm going to do here. Bet three hands for $20 at Twin River Casino in blackjack. First of all, five comes out. I don't know if they burn the card and show the card or not at Twin River, but if they do, great. If not, whatever. I'll still play blackjack anyway. So let's begin with 7, 10, jack, dealer's secret hold card, of course. 7 meets an ace and becomes 8 or 18, 16, 12. Gonna offer insurance with an ace, guys, so watch out. Does anybody want insurance? I'd say the answer is no. The dealer does not have blackjack. So we stick here, surrender here. And hit on 12, which busted. Dealer hits off 17, it's 19, and that's a complete and utter loss for $60. Well, that was short, guys, wasn't it? Let's try this again. You mark up 500 and bet 10 for a match. Dealer match blackjack. The next thing you know, you're getting an ace. You got a 7, ace 7. No, yes. No, it's a 5. So, what do you do with ace 7? Holding, I guess, 5? You go gutsy and all in, and you double down. Mark up 500 more, what do you get? 16. Well, that's a bummer. 7, 5, 12, this better bust. 9, 7, 16. So 7 is bust. Now, one of the things I know about certain casinos and what they can let you do with their blackjack tables is, I heard from one person who lives in my building, I'm not going to say who or where she lives, told me that Foxwoods could let you borrow money to gamble at their casino. Mohegan Sun? Well, I don't know. That's a whole other story. But anyway, you take off your markers of $1,000 that you borrow, and you get to keep, give or take, another 1,000. So here's what I would do. I would settle the 200 and give the rest back as a tip for courtesy, saying thank you for letting me play in your casino. We mark up. Next thing you know, you're marking up, say, 100 quarters and 100 nickels. Isn't that pretty cool? They'll let you do that in Vegas, see? But they won't let you do it anywhere else. Can you believe that? Or so I think. See how this these proceeds go once we've got 20, 20, and now a third 20. Some of you might ask me, am I counting cards? Am I teaching myself how to count cards? I can't tell you for personal social reputation reasons. I don't want to get banned from any casino. But we will go over counting cards like right now before we do this. So the count goes 5, which is a plus 1. We burned that. Ace is minus 1. 5 is plus 1. Ace is minus 1. The count is 0. We go 2 plus 1 plus 1. 0. Wait. Go back. I'm kind of fucked up right now, so I just, you know, I don't have to tell you what that means, but you get the whole gist of it. Plus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 1, plus 2, plus 1, plus 2, plus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 2, plus 2. The count is plus 1. So at plus 1, we have 3 sets of $20 on the table. So let's start this shit with the card counting. Plus 1, 4, plus 2, plus 2, plus 1, plus 1, negative, neutral 0, neutral 0, and 2 brings it up to plus 1. What do you do at plus 1 when you have 7, 4 holding against the 2? You double down. And what do you know? It's a 17. So I draw a 6, which brings it up to plus 2. 17 I stay, 17 I stay. Obviously, you don't want to take another bus card, so let's see how this goes. Up. Well, what do you know? Dealer has 21. So from here, this was plus 1, so let's take the count here. Plus 1, 0, negative 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 1, and all these bets lost. And that, my friends, there should show, in some given way, that card counting is not effective. So next herein, you're betting 10 and 10 for side matches. And with that count being at plus 1, we're betting 2 hands, $50 a piece. Let's see how this plays out. If the count is plus 1 now, what will we get in this match? You know? So the first one you get is plus 1 with 9 is still plus 1. Jack makes it neutral 0. Minus 1. Minus 2, minus 3. Oh boy, I think it's a 20 or a blackjack. Nope, it's not a 20, it's not a blackjack. It's not any hand that's any of your business until the game is over. But stay on both hands. Even though there's no match. Card man, you know what I mean. Stay. 16. You have pulled an 8 and busted. Do I really count cards at the casino if I'm gonna bet blackjack? No, I do it for fun. Not to test my skills and compete. Fuck that. But hey, it's all on you if you wanna count cards. Want me to teach you to count cards? The ace, minus 1, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus, no,
And six brings it to neutral zero, jack, minus one, two, zero, minus one, zero, plus one, zero, plus one, zero, plus one, zero, minus one, zero, plus one, zero. Now, give or take this. Sorry, my nose is itchy. Give or take, guys, listen. Yes, I was in special ed classes. I understand that. Yes, I do have autism. I'm a little smooth, so you think. Yes, the answer is yes. I'm teaching myself how to count cards, but I'm going at a very slow rate. But I read books upon it, and this is my study table that I use to test myself for the casino one day. If I want to gamble at a blackjack table in Vegas. Alright, so let's go over the count of the deck of what we played so far. We started with 60, and then we took out money. Yeah, fuck it. Guys, I want to take the time of effort in the hours to reshuffle this deck and do my session all over again. So don't go away. I'm not pausing the movie. I'm not stopping the movie. I'm demonstrating how to riffle and shuffle cards. I'm doing this video to prove to the whole world I can play and deal blackjack. Alright, there we go. Okay, I know I saw the bottom of the deck, but that's only because this is my house, this is my training set. I'm the dealer and the casino boss in this apartment here in East Providence. And I do what I want on my YouTube videos in my apartment. That's the best part about living independently, not in your parents' place. Because if you're doing this in your basement, you know, it's kind of uncomfortable at age 30 when your mom and pa are like, "Hey, it's time for supper!" Yeah, I'm Jacob, by the way. And I tell you guys, you know, if that happened now, you'd be like, "Dad, you're interrupting my fucking feed here." And Dad would come down the stairs like, "Jake, get your fucking ass upstairs for supper and stop screwing around with that goddamn iPhone." Okay. Measure that, take it off the top, and what do we get? There we go. We're all set. How long this video is gonna last. What do you think of that, guys? I'll tell you what, I'll try to make it at least. Sorry, fucking nose is itchy. coronavirus, pick your nose. Sorry, guys, I got an irritable nose, irritable nasal passages. Anyway, on all serious notes, to riffle, shuffle, cut, and have the deck, riffle, shuffle, cut, and have the deck, you take two quarters of each working pile, and here's what you do. I learned this from Vegas Aces on YouTube. Riffle, you strip, and you riffle again. Put it at the center of the working pile. I make any mistakes, and some of you guys are seeing this video, wherever you are, in what part of the world, I don't care where, you leave a comment and let me know, give me advice on how to keep track of which to start at and how. So, we take from there. Where do we start? Yeah, we started at the left. Right now, we're working on the left. Go strip, strip, strip. And then we riffle again and put it at the center of a working pile. We take from the right, 1/4 of each working pile. Riffle. And then strip, strip, strip. And then we riffle again and put it at the center of the working pile. And I could repeat myself and the list would go on and on, but I'm gonna just limit my talking as I'm doing this. So before we continue, left, right, and back to left. Yeah, so here we go. Left. Now to the right. We go back to the left. Study, guys. I'm doing this research myself too. I'm trying to teach myself this kind of stuff. And then we go to the right, take one fraction of the working decks from right to middle, left to middle, etc. You place your four fingers on the cards, like so, on the top edge, and then with your thumbs, you riffle. You push your thumbs up, and then strip, 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 strip. Now let's try riffling again with the left section. Right? You guys watching? Good. I'm glad you are. So, do the same likewise. See, notice how I'm talking a little. Anyway. Las Vegas management or any casino management won't mind if I hook my finger while I'm doing the card gig. A like, subscribe, and leave a comment. That's what I'm going to say right now as I'm doing this right this moment. So, here we go. Put your four fingers on the upper right, the left hand angle each, whatever. Put your, here's how you do riffle. Put your four fingers on the top edges of the cards and let your thumbs do the work. Let's try that again. Let it elevate. And then strip, 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 strip. And then riffle again. Alright, we were right there. Back here. See if I can shuffle a fatter portion. That'll be the tricky part. No, that's okay. It's okay. Alright, let's do this. We got two separate decks of cards. We riffle. That was easy. And then we strip, 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 strip. And now, riffle again. That was also easy. I guess I can do it with two, more than just one half of a deck each. But just to prove it, let's try that again. Yeah, I did that. I did that. Yes, I can. I got potential to be a blackjack dealer. Or any casino dealer. Because nowadays, you know, I know all the tricks of the book, all the games of the house, and shit like that. Sorry, I'm fidgety. I must have shit in my crack. I'm just kidding. But my ass does itch. So, yeah. To change the deer when they're gone. I know, I'm sorry, I'm just a guy. I'm just messing around. Alright? So anyway, we got this on the money. There, folks. Split the deck in half. I do this. You know why I split the deck the way I do? Let me just try this again. My hands are very short, okay? Yeah, I'm a small guy, I'm a short guy, I'm a little guy. But anyway, please excuse me. One moment, I'll be right back. Man, what the fuck? dick. It ain't any of your business what my cock size is. And I gotta wash my underdrawers, dry my ass, or wipe my ass, wash my underdrawers in the hot sink. With hot water and hot soap. Shit, fuck. That's right, folks. It's my channel. It's my choice to swear. Fuck you. I mean, not you guys literally, but I'm just saying that to get notoriety and, like, laughs on the social network. I need soap. I don't have soap. All I have is body wash. That's gonna have to do. And I'm gonna use antiseptic mouthwash to cleanse out the germs. Yeah, I'm washing my underdrawers because I was shitting all day. No, actually, I was sleeping all day. But anyway, I'm gonna wash them. I gotta pre-wash these or put them in the laundry. Pre-treatment, you call it. Yep. There we go. I'm out of the bathroom, but my hands are all wet, so I gotta dry them the fuck off. Yeah, I gotta dry them the fuck off. Not you guys, I'm just kidding. I'm just. You know, I'm grazing with my videos. I don't give a fuck. You know? Fuck the world. Fuck the cops. You know, I'm gonna say that in public because then you get your ass beat by thugs and cops. You know? Cops. The cocks. The police force cop theme. The new cops theme should be the cock song. The Cockalooly song, they call it. They should call it the Cockalilu song. The new cops theme. The cops theme. Still itchy. I don't know why. I don't give a shit. I'll itch my ass on public fucking internet and nobody's gonna do a thing about it because it's legal to itch your ass on YouTube. Isn't it? I mean, some of the swears I'm saying and some of the things I'm doing, you know, they might be a little questionable to like several people, but who's to say this people's gonna see this video tomorrow and then the police be showing up at my door tomorrow with the FBI agent saying, "Jake, is this your video?" And I'll be like, "Yeah."
"Come with us, you're going to jail."
Anyway, this is not about that. That's all bullshit. This is about blackjack right here. Blackjack, well, one thing's for sure, you can't swear at a casino. But I'm not going to swear in a casino. If I work someday at a casino as a blackjack dealer, first I gotta know how to play the game and then deal the game. The pussy police.
Boom, 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 boom.
The cops.
Yo,
the cops.
The pussy police. Fuck the police. Sheesh, you bastard!
African humor.
Fuck the police, you bastard! Fuck the police, you bastard!
Yep. After all that said and done, what I just went through in the video, right before I went into the bathroom and fucked around there, I beat my meat. We riffle again, put it in the center of the working pile, and repeat the process.
Fuck the police, you bastard!
I killed me.
Fuck the police, you bastard!
Hey, in Scotland it would be more like, hey, fuck the police, you dumb fucking bastard!
Fuck the police, you dumb fucking bastard!
Fuck the police, you dumb fucking bastard! Rolling the deck. We are rolling the deck. We are cutting the deck. Like I said, this is my house. We play by my rules in my casino. I'm the only one that can look at the back of the cards, not you. Because in this house, with my blackjack table, I am a semi-professional demigod artist. Blackjack demigod, you can call me. But in all truth, I am not a god, that's for sure. Next, we start all over again. Let's start again. Two hands. $30 a pop goes with burning a card. Let's just say Twin River doesn't burn a card and show it, of course. The dealer does burn a card, obviously, but there's no way to determine what casino does what, so we'll just leave it at that. And go with 5, queen, 11, 20, 6, on 6, hit it. Alright, 15 will have to stay against 6, and then 20 also stays. You never split 10s no matter how low the dealer's card is, because I've done that thing before where I'm splitting 10 value cards against a very low card to get two better powerhouse hands. But you don't want to do that. That's a sucker's play. So you stay on 20. So you got 9. Dealer has 5 and gets 14. 14 hits with 4 and reveals 18. So you lost this hand, and you won the other hand. Basically, you broke even. No fooling. Now, if you're really tough, bet the whole 60. 2, 6, that's 8 on 8. You gotta hit it. You have no choice, you gotta hit it. You have 12.
Let's cross our hands, folks. Oh, that's a loss. And the dealer had 18 the whole time. Would have lost anyway. Right?
I mean, that's not a fucking hands.
Wanna go again? Actually, guys, this is my cutoff point right now. Stay tuned for more of my videos in the next days of weeks to come.
And Joe Biden can kiss my ass.